Hi, good afternoon. There are certain things that I really wanted to add with respect to the strength, which I was unable to do it in my previous presentation. Now, strengths, one has to remember that focuses on two things. One is it is internal to the company and it has a lot of positive factors. So one has to remember that when you are going to analyze more about the strength, two things has to be remembered. This is internal for the business and the company or the organization, and a lot of positive factors needs to be added out here. For example, our strengths describe the positive attributes, tangible and intangible, internal to the organization. They are within our own control. When I say our own control, it means that it is in the control of the management or the business person or the investors and the stakeholders. Now, what do you do very well? What is it that you excel in? What internal resources do you have? Think about the following. Like what? Positive attributes of people such as knowledge, background, education, credentials, network, reputation, or skills. Now, what is it that I need to focus on? Tangible assets of the company such as capital, credit, existing customers or distribution channels, patents or technology. Now, what is it that my business really excels in that I can really share it with the outside world? What advantages do you have over your competition? Do you have strong research and development capabilities on manufacturing facilities? Now, what is it? Like, R&D is a very important department for any organization because they continuously do it. Now, Nestle, I know, they say that they invest a lot of money to do the research continuously, and they have developed that particular team because the research team not only focuses on the revenue and the profit, they even tell us regarding the product and if the product is already present, is there any need to redesign it or to think about the innovative way in which different products. Now, for example, you can take it up for Nestle. When Nestle has got so many, branches of the company spread across the globe, then they will have to work with respect to some of the products aligned with the particular city or the locality that is available. For example, in India, they have a branch here and they focus a lot about their branches also and the products that are being taken care and launched in the market. Now, for example, in India, we have Maggi noodles coming in variety of flavors. Now, it is not just one taste that we are talking about. Initially, it was only the masala flavor. However, now we get achari flavor is there, green mirchi wala, I think so. They have got pepperdine. Then they have got the Chinese tadka, they say. Then there is one more called as tadka flavor. Now I'm saying that ghar ka swad has come up. Now, so you know, the varieties are there for us. Now, how are they going to launch? When can the same, or in other words, I can say, can the same Maggi noodles work out very well in Mexico? No, there they'll have to focus on the different brands that they have got for the coffee products. So, coffee is very popular in the same manner. Season, now they can not just focus, okay, they launch the products, you know, for summer, a different kind of a product was available, and for winter it was a different kind of a thing. Now similarly for the demographic, when children, the first product that they started off with was with the baby food, which they call it as lactogen. Now later on, you know, they said that it is not just for the baby below the 12 months, it has to be between 12 to 2 years also. They started working on that. Then they observed that yes, there are individuals who are working so hard, we need to launch a product which is going to be helpful and help them to retain their strength and nutrients. So they came up with a different product. Then if we see for women, they came up with a different milk product altogether. Similarly, the fruits, now the demand has come for the healthy, hygienic and eco-friendly products for them. So they have launched plenty of them. Now, how is it that they are able to do it? It is because of the R&D, or what we call it as the research team, which is present for them, and they are able to create and innovate new products and proceed further in the market. Now similarly, one can even see that what other aspects or internal to the business add value or offer you a competitive advantage over the others. So these are certain things that I really missed out in my discussion on strength. So I thought, okay, let me just share it over here once again in a different part altogether. I think I'll stop here and we will proceed further with more on weaknesses. I missed out on that also. In my next part, I would be discussing on it. Thanks.